Hello students, so now we are studying 5.2. In the 5.2 exercise, we have five major important points. First, how a complex number be represented on graphical. It means it is said to be argand plane. The geometrical representation means this is argand plane or argand diagram. The meaning is a complex number x plus iota y, then x, this means, is abscissa, and y, the imaginary part, is ordinate. For example, complex number 2 plus 3 iota, correct? Then x coordinate is 2 and y coordinate is 3. Where we plot x 2, 1, 2, y 3, 1, 2, 3, 2 comma 3 is the coordinate. It is said to be argand plane or argand diagram. Suppose the second complex number, say 2 minus 3 iota, then x equals to 2 and y equals to minus 3. So where we plot 2 minus 3, x equals to 2 but y minus 3, and so on. The same as class 10th, we can plot in all the four quadrants. Easy? Now the point is, what is the conjugate of z? Conjugate of z means, if you want to calculate conjugate, then the representation is z bar. It means the imaginary quantity sign will be reversed. It means if it is plus, make it minus. If it is minus, make it plus. For example, this z bar is 2 minus 3 iota. And if I want to calculate z2 bar, then z2 bar equals to 2 plus 3 iota. The meaning is, if z bar 2 bar, it is simply again z. Kyunki ek bar sign kiya, change kiya, to ye ho gaya. और वापिस उसका साइन चेंज करेंगे तो ये हो जाएगा. अब प्लॉट कैसे करेंगे? 2 प्लस 3 आयटा बाय द वे हियर 2 3, देन व्हाट अबाउट इट्स कॉन्जुगेट? कॉन्जुगेट इज 2 माइनस 3 हियर, बिकॉज दिस इज पॉजिटिव वाई एंड दिस इज नेगेटिव वाई, बट एक्स 2 रिमेन सेम. सो हाउ वी प्लॉट जेड एंड जेड बार? इफ जेड इज हियर, इट्स इमेज जेड बार इज हियर. इफ जेड इज हियर, देन जेड बार इज हियर. सो वी कैन चेंज द कोऑर्डिनेट, बिकॉज the imaginary quantity sign will be replaced by plus 2 minus and minus 2 plus. That's why these are the conjugate. Now the next point comes, what is modulus of a complex number? How we calculate the modulus? Modulus means this distance, that is hypotenuse. Z bar is nothing but, for example, for this question, 2 square plus 3 square, the gap. What we are getting, 4 and 9, 13. But it should be always positive. Why? Because it is a distance. It is denoted by mod z. It's said to be modulus of a complex number z. So in general, z bar modulus equals to x square plus y square under root. If you want to calculate for z bar, suppose it is x minus iota y. What is z bar? X minus iota y. So again, x square plus minus y square, no change. Answer is x square plus y square. So conclusion is, the mod z is same as conjugate of, these two are the same. Z modulus and z bar modulus equals to same. For example, this 2 plus 3 iota is here and 2 minus 3 iota in the fourth quadrant. When we calculate the value of z bar, distance remains same, but the position is changed. Clear? Now the next is, if you multiply z into z bar, what we will get? Here we write, mod z is under root x square plus y square, and mod z bar is x square plus y square. Now the major important, what is z into z bar? If you multiply these two, what we are getting? Very important. Z into z bar, x square minus iota y square. Because algebra a plus b and a minus b, that is a square minus b square, that's why a square minus b square. It is nothing but, because iota square is minus 1, so it will become plus. So z into z bar is nothing but x square plus y square. Now tell me, what about mod z square? is x square plus y square. What is mod z bar square? X square plus y square. Mod z square is same, mod z bar square is same, and z bar is same. So what is the conclusion? Is the most important point, z bar is nothing but mod z square or mod z bar square. Remember, very very important formula which we can use in different questions. Correct? Now, next important point comes, what is argument or amplitude? Here you see that from the positive direction to this hypotenuse, this angle is theta. How we calculate tan theta? Tan theta is perpendicular by base. So theta equals to tan inverse. What we read is tan inverse y by x. This theta is known as amplitude or argument of the complex number z. So how we write it? Theta equals to tan inverse y by x. Y means imaginary quantity, x means real quantity. It means, in short, we can write tan inverse imaginary part of z divided by real part of z. Very important point, that what is amplitude and argument. The principal value of amplitude or argument lying between minus pi to pi. Correct? Now, for example, any complex number, say 1. How we calculate? Say, complex number root 3 plus root 3 iota is in quadrant number first, root 3 and root 3. Correct? We want to calculate its argument theta. So argument theta is y by x. Y by x. This is a real part. This is imaginary part. So what's the value? Tan inverse root 3 by root 3. What we are getting? Tan inverse 1. Ab socho. 10 ki table mein, 10th class mein 1 kab aata tha? 45 degree. It is both the numbers positive and positive in quadrant number 1. That's why your answer is nothing but 5 by 4, because it is in quadrant number 1. By the way, the same is in quadrant number 2. Root 3 is now minus, but height is root 3. Now, what is theta? How we calculate theta? So this time, root 3 upon minus root 3. But the important point, you have to take only the absolute value. And absolute value is 1. Okay? It means we have to write pi by 4. But since it is in quadrant number 2, what we write? 180 minus theta. What is 180 minus theta? Theta is pi by 4. So here we write pi minus pi by 4. That means 4 pi, so it will become 3 pi by 4. Answer of this argument is 3 pi by 4. Right? Now few problems. How to plot these complex numbers in argand plane? And then how we calculate its amplitude or argument as well as modulus? All the three parts. First, second and third. So first we start with 3. 3 means 3 comma 0. That is 3 plus 0 iota. It means 1, 2, 3. By the way, 1, 2, 3. So here it is 3, 0 is the geometrical representation. What about its modulus? Modulus is this square plus this square. That is under root of 9. Under root of 9 is 3. So modulus of z is 3. Now argument of z. Argument of z means this upon this. So here we write tan inverse 0 by 3. That is 0, angle is 0, correct? In part minus 3. minus 3 means minus 3, 0. Correct. So minus 3, 0 is 1, 2, 3. It is minus 3, 0. What is margin? Is 3, because minus 3 square, that is 9, under root of 9 is 3. Now what is angle? Angle is complete pi, that is on the y-axis, angle is pi, 180 degree. Third is 3i, we can write it 0 plus 3i. Theta, 0 plus 3i is here, 0, but 3i by the way. So angle is pi by 2. And what about modulus? Modulus is again 3 square is 9. 9 under root is 3. So modulus is 3. Geometrical representation, 0 plus 3 iota here. Modulus is 3 and theta is pi by 2. Next is minus 3i. Minus 3i you have to go back to this point. 0 minus 3i. So here we write 0 minus 3i. Modulus, same 3, and argument, this time like this or back, what we say, minus pi by 2. Why minus pi by 2? This one is pi by 2, back this one is minus pi by 2, here we write minus pi by 2. Next is 3 plus 3 iota, where is 3 comma 3? By the way, here 3 comma 3. What about its argument? And what about its modulus? So first we calculate modulus. 9 plus 9, that is root 18, and root 18 we can write as 3 root 2 is the mod z. Now argument z is tan inverse 3 by 3, that is tan inverse 1. In which quadrant? Quadrant number 1, that means 1 comes in the tan at pi by 4. So it is in quadrant number 1. What we say, argument of Z is pi by 4. Correct? So these are the 4 important points: geometrical representation, conjugate of Z, modulus, and what is argument, and what is principal argument. Remember, principal argument always lying between minus pi to pi. Now we come to the another point, that is polar representation of a complex number. How we represent a complex number in the polar form? First, what is polar form? Any complex number, say z, is say x plus iota y. Very important. Z a complex number x plus iota y. Then its complex, this complex, we can convert it into another form, that is polar form. What is polar form? This x equals to r cos theta, and this y equals to r sine theta. It means this representation we can write as r common. Inside it is cos theta plus iota sine theta. It is said to be polar form. Where r is nothing but mod z, and theta is nothing but argument of z. Yani ki jisko modulus aur argument nikalna aata hai, usko polar form banana aata hai. Simple. So first we start with a question in 4 parts. First part, let the question is 1 plus iota. Second part, minus 1 plus iota. Third part, minus 1 minus iota. And fourth part, 1 minus iota. All the 4 quadrants, 4 complex numbers, and we want to calculate its polar form. So first we start with the first quadrant. First, let it be z1. Tell me, what about its modulus? 1 square plus 1 square, that is root 2. Modulus is root 2. Modulus of this one, root 2. Modulus of this one, root 2. And modulus of this one, root 2. All the 4 complex numbers, z1, z2, z3, z4, their modulus equals to root 2. Very simple, because 1 and 1. Real quantity 1, imaginary quantity 1, minus 1, but if you square it, 1 plus 1, root 2. So very clear. It means for z1, z2, z3, and z4 we are writing modulus is root 2. No problem. This is say z1, this is z2, this is z3 and z is z4. So modulus is the same, r is the same. Now we have to write the important point, that is theta. And how we calculate theta? That is argument. Y upon x. First you say only its modulus value. Don't say plus minus. So 1 by 1, that is 45 degree. 1 by 1, 45 degree. 1 by 1, 45 degree. 1 by 1, 45 degree. Don't say plus minus. Only absolute value of x and y. It means pi by 4. Now the rule is, if it is in the first quadrant, then theta. If it is in the fourth quadrant, minus theta, because clockwise. And second quadrant, it is 180 minus theta, because 180 is the line, minus theta. And this one is minus of pi minus theta. So yahan theta hai, to yahan minus theta, yahan pi minus theta, to yahan minus of pi minus theta. We will make it with the red. Very important point, theta. Here it is minus theta, here pi minus theta, and here minus of pi minus theta. Most important point. So now we can write very easily. First is cos theta plus iota sine theta. Yes or no? Because it is in the first quadrant. Second number is z2. Theta is same pi by 4. So here we can write cos pi minus pi by 4. Iota sine pi minus pi by 4. For the third one, the same but with minus quantity, that is put minus out, 4 minus 3, 3 pi by 4 plus iota sine minus 3 pi by 4. Very simple. And the last one, cos of minus pi by 4 plus iota sine of minus pi by 4. And now you know the AC system. What is sine of minus theta? Minus comes out. What is cos of minus theta? Remain cos theta. What is sine of minus? Minus comes out. What is cos of minus? Same. And you can convert it. But don't put the values again. Otherwise you will get the same complex numbers. These are the very important how we convert the complex numbers into its polar form. Final conclusion is, first step, you have to calculate the modulus, first step. Second step, you have to plot the points according to their quadrant system. Then how we calculate argument? If it is in first quadrant, theta. If it is in fourth quadrant, minus theta. If it is in second quadrant, pi minus theta. And if it is in third quadrant, minus of pi minus theta. So note down, this is the most important diagram for polar representation. Now we come to the question number 8. See, revision. First we have to calculate r, that is modulus. How we calculate? Root 3 square plus 1 square. 1, root 3. Answer is 3 plus 1, that is 2. 2 is the value of r. Now plot the point is in the first quadrant, correct? So theta, 1 divided by root 3, tan inverse 1 by root 3, in class 10th, you know it is at pi by 6, 30 degree. Since it is in first quadrant, theta remains pi by 6. Now the answer is 2 cos pi by 6 plus iota sine pi by 6. It is the polar form. If you substitute the values like class 10, you will get the question root 3 plus y again. Suppose the same question is in quadrant number 4th. It means it is root 3 minus iota. Then what is the small change? 2 remains 2, but quadrant is 4th. That's why what we write cos of minus pi by 6 plus iota sine of minus pi by 6. If it is in quadrant number 2, that is x is negative, but iota is positive, then again modulus remains 2. But since it is in quadrant number 2, what we write for theta? Cos pi minus pi by 6 sine pi minus pi by 6. What a simple. And if it is in quadrant number 3, that is x negative, y also negative, modulus remains same. But what about the argument? Cos of minus 6, 5 iota sine. What a simple. अब इसके बाद तो एसी से जानते ही हैं कैसे हम इसको माइनस बाहर लाएंगे और इसका माइनस खा जाएंगे, करेक्ट। तो ये हमने पार्ट टू प्रूव किया, कंप्लीट किया, एक्सरसाइज नंबर 5.2 कंप्लीट कर लेंगे होमवर्क में, गुड। ये कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर को बहुत ध्यान से पढ़ना है क्योंकि आर्ग्यूमेंट और मॉडलेस में थोड़ा सा बच्चों को डाउट रहता है, करेक्ट। जैसे कि लास्ट टॉपिक में किस में डाउट रहता था, मल्टीप्लिकेटिव इनवर्स में। मल्टीप्लिकेटिव इनवर्स में कई बच्चों के कमेंट्स भी आए। मल्टीप्लिकेटिव इनवर्स का मीनिंग है सिंपल, वन अपॉन दैट कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर। लेकिन क्योंकि हमको आयोटा डिनोमिनेटर में नहीं चाहिए इसलिए हम उसको क्या कर देते हैं, उसका रेशनलाइजेशन कर देते हैं। बाय द वे मेरे को मल्टीप्लिकेटिव इनवर्स चाहिए 2 प्लस 3 आयोटा का, तो मैं क्या बोलूंगा इसका मल्टीप्लिकेटिव इनवर्स, ये बोलूंगा क्योंकि इसको इससे मल्टीप्लाई करने पर 1 आएगा। मगर इसको मैं ऐसे तो नहीं छोड़ सकता, तो मैं क्या करूंगा इसका 2 माइनस 3 आयोटा, 2 माइनस 3 आयोटा। तो कल के लेक्चर में ये कमेंट्स थे बच्चों के, हाउ वी कैलकुलेट मल्टीप्लिकेटिव इनवर्स। सो दिस इज द सिंपल शॉर्टकट, ओके। तो कंटिन्यू करते रहिए, पढ़ते रहिए, बढ़ते रहिए, हम आगे मिलते हैं कॉम्प्लेक्स का क्वाड्रेटिक फॉर्म लेकर के। तब तक टेक केयर, गुड बाय।